Today I'm at the Plantation Club in Sea Pines, and I'm going to do a little bit of short game today. Now, whenever I get the chance to, I come to the short game area, and I do a drill, which is, it's fun, but it can be very stressful. So the drill is, I got 10 balls, and I'm going to a short fly so in case this right one over here. Every time it's a pretty tough shot, so it kind of challenges my short game. But the objective is to get even par better. So 20 shots, and it should be easy to figure out that if I make one, and I have the rest twos, I break par. But sometimes I'm here for an hour just trying to get even. It's very stressful. Sometimes you're on, because I start from the shortest putt and go out. If I'm at the longest putt and I miss it and I'm at even, that means I finished one over, so I got to start over. So here we go.
Right, so again, just to wrap up what Karl's got to do, he's got 10 balls, all of a similar quality to what he plays with. And he's got to practice getting up and down from the second cut of rough there, and leaving it at a distance where he can realistically get up and down. So if you've seen any of his videos lately, you'll see that he gets up and down a lot of the time. Now you can see he played that shot differently and the ball ran past. It's the quickest way to build up your short game skills. Nearly got it, but it's run past. So he's gonna have to come in with a bit more loft. Otherwise, he's just going to keep on running past. You see, he landed that probably 3 inches short of the green, and the fringe killed it. That should be good. Boom, that's in. So that's going to help him there, because he's got one ball that ran about 6 feet past. So that one that ran, that's closer to 10 feet. For that one that ran 10 feet past, if he doesn't sink it, he's going to need to have at least one ball in the hole there. He's got one ball in the hole. This could be close. Could be close. So you can see that we scatter the... Carl, there's one more ball around there.
No.
Yeah. So you can see that we scatter the balls around, so he's got a different lie with each shot. We're not just placing the ball down for each shot. He's got to really earn his keep. He's tried to run that one up there and he just got it a little bit weak, so I don't like his chances of sinking all nine of the balls that didn't go in. But we'll see. That's a gimme. None of the others are gimmies. So as it stands now, because that one he just threw away was a gimme, he stands at one under par. Yes, as I say, if you watch some of Karl's videos lately, you'll see he gets up and down a lot of the time. And the reason he gets up and down a lot is not accidental, because he practices that particular skill. And being Karl's dad, I can tell you that it gets very tense out here when he gets so close to breaking par and then misses the very last ball. Where the stress really builds up. It's a good looking putt. Oh, it's a good putt. These greens here are very firm. So he's now square with the card after missing that putt. He's still got two balls there to sink to remain square with the card. Now this is his first set he's doing, so he'll just keep on doing this set until he breaks par for the 10 balls. One over. Two over. So you can see his focus went there at the end. So now he starts it all over again. So we're starting the second set now. This exercise is designed to teach you to get really good feel with your hands, really soft feel, because if you grip the club tight, the ball's just going to go a mile off the club face. Now he's barely touched that. These greens at Sea Pines here, which is where Harbour Town is played, are like grease lightning. You can see he just landed that below the line of where he should have landed that. So it's not just about the trajectory here. You see he's closer to the green there, he so came in with a more traditional bump and run. There's a couple balls there that he'll be able to do this, that with, but this one he's going to have to throw it up a little bit. Ooh, he's lucky there. I reckon that would have gone a few feet past. I'll just move these other balls here so that he can get at the hole. Well, he doesn't want me to move those two balls that are blocking the hole. Better hit something. Yeah, it's not bad. A little bit hot. Should be close. You can see those balls are blocking him being able to sink a ball with this particular shot, and if he does that clever shot he's just trying to do, it then gives him the possibility of missing that putt. Same again here. Karl, I know what you're trying to do. You're trying to knock one of those balls in, but you risk bringing a bogey into play. Sort of hard to figure out what you're trying to do there, bud, because look how far those last four went. So three of those there are gimmies, so we'll just hit those away. And Karl can't possibly break par because he didn't sink any of the balls. It's still par. Par is two. Ooh. One of the best drills you can use for practicing getting up and down. This will break right to left. Oh, it didn't break. So he cannot beat one over for this particular set. So he's going to start again. He's got to finish at least square, preferably one under. The only way he can finish one under is by sinking one of his chips, holing one of his chips. So he starts his third set. Oh, good chip. Soft hands. Soft hands. Let's run past a bit. You've got to have such soft hands when you play these little flop shots here. See, it came in a bit lower then and it ran on. He's getting very aggressive with these chips. He's trying to sink one. If he wasn't being aggressive, they would all be inside of 2 or 3 feet. This one could be close. Had the line. So he's changed clubs here. Now he's got a sand wedge in his hand because he doesn't need as much loft. He's going to try and do basically a bump and run. Oh, got away with it. That could have really shot through then. Good speed. This could be in. Yes, so now he's got the chance if he can sink all of these putts. Well, we might get a second one here. Now he's got the chance if he can sink each of these balls to stay at one under. But he's got a very good chance of at least coming out square, which is the object of this exercise. So those are all gimmies, those three. Or four, sorry, because one was in the hole. Right, this is where you must maintain your focus. If you miss one of these like he just did then, with a stupid miss, then he's just messed it up. He just lost, it was his easiest putt that he had, he wasn't focused and he messed it up. So now the best he can do is even if he sinks all of these harder putts. This exercise develops concentration. Now he's having to focus a lot harder than he should have. It's that dumb first putt. Exactly. Very frustrating miss with his first putt on the third set. Here he is on the fourth set. Well, it's taken a bad kick. He's at a tougher angle here because he's actually hitting on a downslope now. And it's very hard to get these close. Most of these, I would hazard a guess, will go past the flag. That's about the only way he could not go past the flag. This could be in. So he's hitting from the second cut here. It's thickish grass. That could be in. Boom. Lucky he hit the flag. That was past it by a good 3 or 4 feet otherwise. Good speed. Good speed. Karl's using soft hands with this wedge. If you grip the club too tightly, the ball's going to run through a country mile. This could be in. Oof. Right, so most of those I would expect him to sink, but after the last set where he missed his shortest one, you wouldn't put money on it. So he stands one under with 8 balls to finish off. He's going to take his focus on these short ones this time. So he didn't focus on his first short putt last time and missed it because he didn't give it the level of respect that it deserved. How often in tournaments do you guys miss these putts? These are the clutch putts, guys. So Karl gave the hole away there from 3 feet and paid the price. So he's now square. He can't possibly shoot under. So square is the best result he can get. Hopefully he doesn't give the hole away again on this putt. Oh, good putt. Right, this 6 footer to finish square, and then we can go back home and watch the Saturday's play of the Cadillac Match Play Championship. But he's got to sink this for us to be allowed to go home. Oh, he's done it.
Well, that was only 4 tries. I'm pretty happy with that. Just the stupid putt here I missed from like 1 foot. But I'm pretty happy with my chipping. It's good.